Wiring in Barotrauma can be complicated, but I'm going to share with you 4 beginner-friendly wiring projects that you can try in your submarine right now, even if you've never done wiring before. We're going to start with 2 easy and fun ones, then one project that's a little harder, and lastly, my favorite wiring design, which is super easy and fun as well. Let's start with motion detector doors. After you get your screwdriver, a motion detector, and a wire, put the motion detector right in the middle of the door while it's open. Wire the motion detector to the door's set-state socket, and after that, we'll do some configuring. Press E on the motion detector with a screwdriver. You can configure this however you want, but I'll configure it so that it only detects humans, and I'll check the box that says ignore dead so it doesn't detect corpses. You can also fine-tune the motion detection area with these settings, but I won't touch these for this door. The important part is though, output and false output. Output is a signal the detector gives when it detects a movement, and false output is a signal it gives when it doesn't detect a movement. As you can see, output says 1, this means it'll open the door when it detects a movement, and the false output says 0, so it'll close the door when it doesn't detect a movement. And there we have it. It opens when there's movement, and closes when there's no movement. However, if you just want automatically closing doors and not motion detector doors, you can leave the output empty and only put 0 in the false output so it doesn't open with movement, but if it's open and there's no movement, it'll close on its own. That's the basic knowledge you need to know to make a motion detector door. Also, I believe the submarine Camel doesn't have any detectors on any of its doors, so you can try to upgrade the doors to your liking with motion detectors. Next up, emergency descent portable pump. For this one, you'll need to be a mechanic and have the talent let it drain to get a portable pump. In addition to a portable pump, make sure to have a wire, a screwdriver, and some kind of battery. A full-bearing battery might be a good choice because the portable pump uses a lot of power really quickly. What you want to do for this design is find a spot in your submarine with a lot of space, preferably a spot that doesn't contain any vital stuff. And once you find it, this spot will be used as your emergency ballast to descend quickly in dire situations. Place your portable pump, and while it has no battery, press the power button and adjust the pumping speed to +100%. After that, wire the toggle state socket of the portable pump to the navigation terminal's signal out socket. Any of these 3 signal out sockets will work, and you can also use a button if you don't have any sockets left in the terminal. Place a battery in the portable pump, and now, when you press the button, you'll fill this area with water and descend really fast. Also, make sure to give a briefing to your captain on how and when to use this button so he doesn't drown the crew. And that's it. You've got yourself an emergency descent portable pump. Next up, low fuel alarm for the reactor. For this design, we'll need 1 memory component, 1 grator component, 1 alarm buzzer, and 3 wires. Before getting into the design, we have to first understand what these 2 components do. The memory component, as the name suggests, remembers stuff, and in this case, it will remember a number value that we put in. Greater component, as the name suggests, checks if some number is greater than some other number and gives an output depending on that. So if the signal in 1 socket is bigger than the signal in 2 socket, it will give a true output. If not, it will give a false output. Now that we know how these components work, this is how the design works. We want the alarm to buzz when the fuel rod is less than 5%. We'll write the value 5 to the memory component and then wire the memory component to the greater component. Also, we'll wire the fuel percentage left socket of the reactor to the greater component as well. And then the greater component will give a true output if the number 5 is greater than the fuel percentage left. Wire the greater component to the alarm buzzer, and bam, the alarm should buzz if value 5 is bigger than the fuel percentage. Now that we understand how it works, let's do it for real. Put the memory component and the greater component near the reactor. Open the memory component and write 5 into the value. Wire the memory component's signal out socket to the greater component's signal in 1 socket. Wire the reactor's fuel percentage left to the greater component's signal in 2 socket. And also, make sure to set the false output of the greater component to zero. This way it will stop the alarm buzzer when it gives a false output, just like we did with the motion detector. Then wire the greater component's signal out socket to the alarm buzzer's set state socket. And voila, our low field reactor alarm should work now. If you want to see how it's working, you can change the number on the memory component to something higher. We have 74% fuel left on the reactor. If you set the memory component's value to 75, the alarm will buzz because the fuel rod's percentage is less than 75. You can also put a text display somewhere and wire the reactor's fuel percentage left socket to it to see the fuel percentage left. And yeah, that's basically it. We have a working low fuel alarm. And now you can configure this design to your liking. Putting more alarms around the sub, changing the fuel left number to something higher. Who knows, play around and have fun with it. Keep in mind that this design will only work if you're using one fuel rod. If you want to do it with more fuel rods, you'll need to do some wiring magic with a divide component and another memory component. Phew, that was a lot of complicated wiring. Let's finish with something light. Next up is my favorite wiring design in Barotrauma. Fixfoam grenade detonator. It's simple, it's fun, and it's super useful. For this design, you'll need to have the hull fixer talent from the mechanics tree or have a mechanic that can supply you with Fixfoam grenades. Once you have some grenades, make sure to have a screwdriver, a button, a wire, and a detonator. You can't craft detonators, so you'll need to buy some if you don't have any. When you acquire everything you need, find a spot in your submarine that gets constant hull breaches. This spot can be a ballast that gets attacked a lot, or a part of the submarine that's both vulnerable and hard to reach. Place your detonator, put the Fixfoam grenade in, and wire the detonator to a button. Ideally, this button should be somewhere you stay a lot so you can reach it easily, and that's it. You have a Fixfoam grenade detonator set up for emergency repairs. You can put more of these in different spots of the submarine and do hull repairs without moving an inch. That's all the designs I have for today. If you want to learn more wiring designs, I have an awesome Steam guide made by QWERTY18 in the description. This guide helped me a lot in making this video, so maybe it'll help you learn new stuff as well. I might do more of these videos with intermediate wiring designs and maybe even with your designs that you share in the comments. So feel free to share your own wiring improvements in the comments below. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys later in the next video. Bye bye!